там телевизионная девушка там.
Увенивши, шоу венивши.
Думаю, подожди, отца, отца, будут поменять уже.
Welcome back to our coverage of these junior trap events. It's the men next. This is qualification, by the way. It was an interesting one as well. We had a five-way shoot-off between third and seventh to see who would get into the final. And unfortunately, Alberto Facci ended up seventh after missing his first target. And then the other four had to decide which way round they would be, because of course bib number is all important here. And let's introduce you to these athletes who have made it through. This is Daniel Marojek. First time he's qualified in the top 20 for the 17-year-old, so a big moment for Daniel Marojek. There's the coach making her way around to her seat.
Representing Great Britain, Michael Bovington.
Well, Great Britain had the gold in the women's junior. Can they do the same here? Michael Bovington getting the same vocal support. And Christine coming to his seat. Certainly, almost like a football crowd in the back there, enjoying themselves. Lorenzo Franquillo next up, the 19-year-old junior double trap European Championship bronze a couple of years ago. Best in trap, 45th at the Junior World Cup in 2019. And Alberto Pera will be his coach.
On position three, representing Spain, Javier Martinez Fuster.
Javier Martinez Fuster is our next athlete. The 20-year-old, Bovington's 20, so the second 20-year-old in his first final. Best is 10th in the Junior World Championships in 2018. 11th is best in the European Junior Championships. Now, there's always a Russian around, and they're always looking to be on the top of the podium. This is Kirill Bagrov, the 17-year-old. Made the World Cup final in Cairo. He was 6th. Very, very impressive from him. Qualifying top, another Spaniard. 118 his qualification numbers. This is a 17-year-old Andreas Garcia, who missed the fist pump with Kuna. Never mind. He'll shake the shoulders. I don't think Kuna saw him, to be fair. He certainly wouldn't diss an athlete, that's for sure. That much I know of the man. And it's the same officials as for the women's. Let's hope we have a slightly less troublesome machinery here for this competition. Certainly was an exciting finish, wasn't it? And here is our Cypriot referee in charge. And he always does the fist bump with Kuna.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more applause for our Track Band Junior finalists.
So those are our six, hoping to be on the top step in a few moments' time. Remember, it's 50 targets for each athlete if they are going to get to that gold medal. After 25 targets, first athlete leaves. 30 targets, the second athlete leaves. After 40 targets, we know who's got the bronze. 10 more targets, gold and silver. Normally are settled. Those are our eight who are hoping it's going to be their day today. Somebody has to be top of the podium. Garcia gets us underway with a miss. Oh dear. Here's Bagroff. Way high into the left. No problem at all. Martinez Fuster. And a miss from him as well. Well, we saw this in the women's competition, didn't we? Lots of misses early on. Not from Bovingdon, the man from Windsor. Not the most famous resident of Windsor, of course. Was born down the road in Slough. A slightly different kind of town, that one. Martinez Fuster looking good after that miss early on. The two Spaniards to the two misses in that first round. Ooh, straight down the middle and unable to chase it. Franquillo will be disappointed with that. Bovingdon so far so good. Can Mrozek join them at the top of the pile? Ooh, I think that was a miss as well. That was fairly straight but pretty high. Remember, the targets will be taken for one of nine set of tables. Maximum angle is 45 degrees. Of course, the minimum is zero, straight down the middle. And they can be anything from 3 meters high or 1.5 meters high at 10 meters. So obviously, that amplified if they go further than 10 meters. These targets coming out at 120 kilometers an hour. A nasty one away to the right, but Bovington certainly starting well. Another one down the middle. Mrozek, two misses out of two at the moment. Bagroff chasing one away to the right and not catching it. His first miss of the competition. Not hanging around these athletes, are they? 12 seconds once they get ready to call for the target and get it away. Franquillo, two hits in a row now for him. And a nice easy one, or easier one for Bovingdon. Slightly to the right, but again, chasing it nicely. And that's better from the Polish athlete. Andrzej Garcia. Starting to get into the groove as well. Now Bagroff. Not missing that one. Anquilo. And Bovingdon. So he's in the lead. Five out of five for him. Everybody else has missed at least one. You'd be disappointed to miss that one. Mrozek, very stop start. Three misses out of five. A That's the man in the lead at the moment, Michael Bovingdon from the A1 shooting ground. I'm sure everyone there will be watching with bated breath. Rozek at the bottom at the moment, and the Brit Bovingdon at the top as we get going again. Oh, with a miss from Garcia. Pagroff, just the one miss from him. Martinez Fuster with another miss. One behind the leaders at the moment. Bovingdon, though, a chance to maintain an advantage. There's the first miss from the British athlete. Rozek needs to go on a run. He's at the bottom at the moment. Garcia. Oh, that one's a miss away to the left from the Russian, and was unable to follow it. Not dissimilar to that one from the Spaniard. Martinez Fuster, no problem there. Now Franquillo. I mentioned he's also enjoys double trap, but of course not an Olympic sport anymore. So he's obviously forging his way in trap and doing it exceedingly well. Bovingdon back on track. Again, a point ahead of everybody else. Tight though with 3-on-5. Back to Garcia. Qualified top. Kirill Bagroff, the other one, the other athlete, qualified second, and there was a shoot-off. Martinez Fuster and Franquillo, 115. Martinez Fuster winning that one, and then Bovingdon, Melozek, and Alberto Facci trying to make sure they were in the and then getting places, but certainly Bovingdon taking his opportunity here. 3-4-6 now. Bovingdon missing 2 out of the last 3. So he started well, but there's a little bit of a hiccup now. Oh, the 20-year-old. Bagroff and Martinez Fuster are leading the way. Can Franquillo join them? No is the answer by the look of it. Did a hand go up? I don't think it did, actually. Well, they're not going to argue with a hit, are they? Certainly, it only takes a small nibble. Any taken out of that target. Oh, and a miss from Bovingdon. So he's a point behind the leaders now. 3 out of the last 4 missed. See the speed of reaction of these athletes. Really got to be concentrated, focused. And I think we've got a problem with trap number 5 here. It's not the one we've had problems with today so far. Oh dear. Well, it's not really been great in terms of machinery. Has been having a few problems. Are we going to try again, or do we have to go down into the bunker? We're going to try again. Let's see if Garcia can get this one away. Yes, he can. And he does well to keep his concentration. Now Bagroff goes top with 8. Martinez Fuster with a miss. So the Russian ahead. Franquillo can join him. Tricky one. high into the right. He's looking good. Now Bovingdon with a chance to get back in touch. That's nicely done, straight down the middle from the British athlete. Rozek chasing it to the right, but not catching it. You can see, always seem to be a little bit behind on that one. So he is bottom of the pile, 10 targets out of 50 done. Remember, first time we lose an athlete is at 25 targets. Close battle this one, 2 points between top and bottom. It could all change again, that's for sure. Back live, and a miss from Garcia. No problems from Bagroff, looking good after it. Missing early on, has come back in to form. Franquillo. And that will keep him one behind Bagroff. Oh, do we have a VAR protest? I think we do. Well, I have to say, that's a bit of a surprise, but they have eagle eyes, these coaches, you know. And obviously the athletes so intently focused on the target may possibly have seen something as well. Background we go, behind the big screen. That's where our VAR screen is. And everyone else can watch it on the big screen. You're seeing what they will be seeing. We're just waiting for the particular video to be lined up. Franquillo just waiting. Let's have a look. Is that, are they saying it's a broken target coming out? Certainly I can't see that. Is there another angle that might help? Of course, they come out so fast, 120 kilometers an hour. And two of the cameras start tracking it. It's worth just rolling it on to see if there's any deviation in the spin of this target. These coaches having a look, seeing what we can see. Oh, there. I did say spin it on. You can see it. If they just roll it back a bit. Roll it back. And then they've gone past it. I can see the puff of pink powder. I don't know whether you can as well. That's a better shot. Now if they keep rolling that. Keep rolling it. Here we go. Definitely saw something. That seems to tell a different story. Oh dear. Camera never lies, of course. On the other one, you definitely saw a puff of powder, but now they're looking from a different angle. Who'd be a referee? Dedicated bunch. They love the sport. They have a really difficult job to do. They're taking their time. Now this is the shot. If they roll this forward, well, was that a puff of powder from that target? That's what we've got to ask ourselves. There. That may just be a previous target. So. Let's see what they're going to say. Difficult decision for these officials. Oh, there you go. So confirmed as a hit. That was a difficult decision, but there was definitely a puff of powder on that shot, and they obviously decided that came from that target. So well done to Frank Rilo. Long wait for Bovingdon. Oh, what's going on now? Well, he's checking the target next to Bovingdon. He's had to stop. That can't be helpful for the British athlete. Get into your zone. Get yourself ready. See the clock counting down. Well done. Really well done. Coach thinks so as well, because that was a long delay and then another little disruption, but he kept his concentration. That one definitely missed from Mrozek. No challenge. And another miss, this time from Garcia, who's having a few problems of his own. Oh, Bagroff with a miss. Chance for others to catch up with him. Martinez Fuster certainly has. Franquillo goes into the lead. Bovingdon can go within one of the lead here as well. That's a nice target to have. Just cooling down a wee bit here. Some athletes in their shirt sleeves, long sleeves, some in short sleeves. Oh, that's a horrible target for Mrozek. Really high, really wide. You're going to get them. Of course you are. And those are the ones that make all the difference. Remember, after 25 targets per athlete, we will lose our first athlete, and then it all kind of speeds up a wee bit. Ooh, straight down the middle and missed from the Spaniard. Aquilo on the left-hand side, no problems for him. Stays in the lead. That challenge, absolutely crucial. High into the left for the from Windsor, no problem. Rojek now missed his last three. Not that one, that was a tricky one as well, but he did very well. Back to Garcia, the man who qualified top, but is not having it all his own way in this final. Bagroff, after two misses, there's a hit. Grillo maintains his lead. A chance for Bovingdon to stay on his coattails. He moves to 11. Nip and tuck, early stages of this men's junior trap final. Oh, and a miss. Another one. Oh, he's having a torrid time. Four out of the last five for the Polish athlete. And once your mind's gone, perhaps it's difficult to get that consistency back again. Hopefully he's in the zone and it'll come back. Martinez Fuster. Certainly there or thereabouts. And a miss from Franquillo. So here's a chance for Bovington to share the lead again. Well, he did ever so well. Away to the right-hand side. Better from Mrozek. Well done. Hits the last one. Two out of the last three is hit now. But he is adrift by quite some distance. Fascinating battle for the top spot. Franquillo with that challenge. Really important, but he missed the last target, so here's how it's all moved. Bagroff down into a share of third place. Back live, Garcia with the hit. this is a better series for everybody. Tranquillo was very high, and that's a miss. Hovington goes into the lead by a point. Last one up, Morozek looking just to close the gap. And a miss means he stays three behind. Getting closer and closer to that 25 target mark where we'll lose our first athlete. Oh, a miss from Bagroff. Good from Martinez Fuster. Tranquillo, the Italian looking good. Tight at the top, but Morozek struggling to keep in touch with the other athletes. Here he is. Oh, that's a horrible target as well, away to the right. And now he's four adrift. These two Spanish athletes certainly want to be vying for the podium. Target comes out broken. Bagroff just 17 years of age. Astonishing that he was in that final in Cairo. And in the top 30 in Lenato recently as well. British contingent enjoyed the win of Lucy Hall. Here's her compatriot looking to stay on top and does. Once we get to those 25 targets, everything starts to speed up. It's at last for Morozek. Alexey Lipov, busy qualifying today, stays on, it's kept an interest in the junior ranks as well. Miss from Garcia, that's a bit of a blow. Okay, slight problem with the trap machine again. I think we're ready to go. Bagroff. Way to the right and no problem for the Russian. Oh, that was a tricky one to the left, high as well. Disappearing over the high house and out of view. Ooh, and a miss from Bovingdon. Into the sunshine it goes, that target. So it's 15 apiece for Martinez Fuster and Bovingdon. Youngsters enjoying the action as well. Look at the reaction from Morozek. It's just not happening for him at the moment. 9 out of 19. You've got a feel for him. And another miss, this time from Garcia, who's struggling. But he has that cushion from the Polish athlete. So back out again from behind the clouds. Clouds really only massing away to our left. Blue sky above us. That's very smartly done by Bovington. Early on to that shot. Now then, come on. Let's hope for a hit here for Morozek. Yeah, and that was a tricky one as well. Into double figures for the Polish athlete, but he's still three adrift at the bottom. Garcia in a bit of problem there. And well, a share of the lead for Martinez, Fuster and Bovingdon, 16 apiece. And Bagaroff and Franquillo on 15. It's a good old battle, this one. So then, five more targets for these athletes once around these five stations. And then we will know who is our first athlete to leave, and then it all speeds up a wee bit in terms of how often these athletes will have to leave every five targets. Good from Martinez Fuster. Tranquillo keeping the pressure on the leaders. Just a nibble, it's enough for Bovingdon. Now then, Marozek. You very much doubt he's going to be anything other than sixth place. However, if he keeps hitting, you never know. He is the bib number six as well, so a draw with anybody is not going to cut the mustard. It's tight at the top, this one, isn't it? Franquillo can go to within a point. And does. No misses from these athletes in the last series. So far this series. Big cheers from the British contingent. They've been very vocal, haven't they? Yeah, that's much better. Three in a row now from Marozek. He'll be pleased about that. Already on to the 23rd target here of these athletes' final. Martinez Fuster is looking very good. Got a really good run going on here. Bovington's hit his last three. And he's missed there. So down into a share of second place. Three athletes on 18. And a miss from Rozek. He's not going to be coming back from that. He's too far behind. Oh dear, another problem. Let's just see. I have to stand back. I think this might take a bit of time as well. Oh dear. I have to go back down into the trap and sort them out. A referee dashing across the arena to that left-hand side. There he is. His third time he's been down in the bunker. There he goes. Be back in a minute. So just going to sort this out. Hopefully back in a minute. Our referee. It's not ideal, but it is what it is. It's getting a wee bit chilly here. Outside of the sunshine. In the sunshine, not so bad. Temperature just dipped down around this time of night. Just shy. In fact, just ticking into 6:30 local time. It's a beautiful quality of light, but there's no point if we can't get the targets out. We're just fixing a problem with one of the traps. In the meantime, the athletes just have to relax, stretch if you need to, and just wait for these things to be resolved, and they will be. Well, that's Bovingdon. Best so far, fourth 2 years ago in the European Championships. Another year or so in the junior ranks, and then we'll be looking to make his way in the senior ranks. Well, we still haven't seen the referee reappear from the bunker, have we? See a little toe strap. Normally you put the end of the shotgun on, stop it hitting the floor. Doesn't seem to be bothering Bagaroff too much. And there's the beautiful clear sky. Nice evening. I'm sure a lot of people will be... Oh, here he is. You can say strolling along the Drava River on the banks. Beautiful walk there. Yeah, he's probably got dirty hands. Orange hands. Well, well done to our referee. Best to get out of the way now. So a slight delay, but we're still... Oh, almost halfway through this junior men's final. And who was it? It was Garcia, wasn't it? Who was about to get us underway. You can see his blue bracelet indicating that he's been tested for COVID and all is well. And I think, like me, he'll be getting tested again tomorrow on the way in. Anyway, that's not a concern of now. We're back in action. And not long before we lose our first athlete. Martinez Fusta still leading the way. Tranquillo within one. Bovingdon has been there or thereabouts. Had a wobble earlier on. Missed his last one. Didn't miss that one. So Morozek, who is too far behind already, but would love to bag the last couple straight down the middle. That's what is required, nice and easy. So then the last round before we are reduced to five athletes. Quickly done by Martinez Fuster, but he heard the beep, it goes red. Oh, and a miss from Tranquillo as well. This is turning into an eventful last series before we stop and pause. Joint lead, three-way share. And the last target for Daniel Morozek. He bags that one, so well done to him. 25 targets down. We're halfway through. Our first athlete leaves. And unfortunately, it is the Polish athlete, Daniel Morozek, who has to leave. Congratulations to him. First time he's qualified in the top 20 of a competition. Coach giving some consolation. Not been his day. So we lose an athlete after every five shots now, until we go into the gold and silver shoot-off. That means then we have 10 targets. So away we go. It's very tight, isn't it? Garcia, the man who was at the bottom by a point, a miss from Bagaroff, and a miss from Tranquillo. Oh, Martinez Fuster, rather. Now Tranquillo. He doesn't miss. So he joins the party. Bovingdon can go back into the lead here. Oh, and that looked like a miss as well. Okay, four-way tie. He had a real opportunity there, didn't he? He's missed two out of his last four. Bovingdon. It's more how you deal putting it to the back of your mind and going forward, worrying about the next shot. That's really all you should do. Bovington glowing red because, of course, he's the lowest remaining bib number. If everyone's equal, he'll be the man leaving. So he needs to start hitting here. That's not too bad at all. Now Garcia. Nicely done. Bagroff. Missed one a couple of targets ago, not this time. No messing around, is there, from Martinez Fuster. Tranquillo. Good from the Italian. Bovington to stay in touch. Oh, and a miss. A miss. Remember, Garcia is on 21 as well, but Garcia has number one on his back. So Bovington with a bit of work to do. From being top, he's now in danger of dropping out. Having said that, Bagroff has just missed as well. It can all change, remember. Martinez, Fuster going into the lead. Tranquillo could join him. Bovington has to hit. He's missed two out of the last three, and that has dropped him from being in the lead to being in danger of going out. That's better from the British athlete. Well, Garcia, this is a massive target for him. Bagroff has to hit here as well. And he does. So it's Bovington who is going to leave next by the look of it. Tranquillo, a higher bib number. So Garcia will stay in, and Bovington, there's a couple of misses. Well, that's how tight it is. He is the athlete who's going to miss out on a medal. No, his hand went up straight away, but he certainly, it was given as a hit, but it doesn't matter because there's three on 23. And Bovington, because he qualified in fifth place, he's the athlete who has to leave. So Great Britain with the gold in the women's competition, but not in the men's competition. Michael Bovington having to make do with fifth place. What a turnaround that was in the last five targets. Can't miss a couple like he did in the last five targets. The man from Windsor. Well, he put his hand up thinking it was going to be given as a miss. It wasn't. It was given as a hit, but it made no difference. One way or other. So now we're down to four. It's really very, very tight. Martinez Fuster is so quick. And a miss from Tranquillo. There's no challenge, just a scratch of the head from Urbano Pero. Oh, and straight away, VAR comes out. He had a line of sight view of that from Garcia. Spanish coach has requested it. Need to sit down now, really. Nothing else to do. Oh, now the Italian coach is up and having a word. I think he's protesting about Tranquillo's miss, but He didn't say anything at the time, and now we're going to have a look at this from Andreas Garcia. It has to be said that the coach was right in the line of the direction of travel of that and immediately put his hand up, got the VAR out. Both the athlete and the coach waiting to see. All looking now at the big scoreboard, which has the pictures on. Well, haven't really got the angle at the moment. That's the problem here. Well, they're all having a look and trying to work this one out rather than the me, to be honest with you. He was definitely watching it like a hawk, the coach, and was convinced there had been a hit right at the end. I think it was later rather than soon, if you see what I mean. Well, they made a decision. And it's been given as a hit. So, good decision from the coach. It did look like there was something going on that target. I'm right behind him, admittedly a little bit further away. But he was absolutely convinced about that. Well done, the coach. Now Bagroff to stay in touch. Away we go again. Down the middle, no problem at all. Martinez Fuster. Ooh, a miss from the Spaniard. Garcia with a miss this time. Well, we're heading fast towards the 35 target mark when we'll lose our next athlete. Garcia in a spot of bother here. Oh, but a miss, another miss from Martinez Fuster. That's two in a row. The Spanish athlete struggling here. So Bagroff, just one target behind Franquillo. Garcia, keeping himself with hope. Bagroff, keeping himself top of the pile. We'll have to see what Franquillo can do. That's better from the Spaniards. And then the Italian. Oh, he did well, did really well there, and leads by one. So then, is it going to be Garcia? Who goes? He's qualified top. Bagroff has to hit this one, and does. Martinez Fuster is the man who's going to go. Franquillo putting himself top of the pile. Well, that was a tight one, wasn't it? And Garcia and Martinez Fuster are both on 27, but that's the advantage of qualifying top. Garcia, by dint of his bib number, stays in the competition, and it is Javier Martinez Fuster who will miss out by the narrowest of margins on the podium. Three left then. This is the podium sitters, but who will be top of the pile? Five more targets and we lose our bronze medalist. And it will be a straight gold silver shoot off over 10 targets. And of course, your turn to shoot comes thick and fast now. You've got to stay in the zone. Garcia starts well. Now, Bagroff, a 17-year-old, already showing what he can do in senior competitions, looking very good here as well. But Franculo, a miss from the Italian. So, level now with Bagroff. Got to be careful because he has the lowest bib number of the three. And a bit like Michael Bovington, you can go from being in the lead to being chucked out in fifth place. Can change very quickly. Miss from Andreas Garcia. Puts him in a spot of bother with just a couple of targets to go. Oh, another miss. Okay, well, Bagroff and Franquillo, it looks like are going to be in that gold medal duel. Garcia, the 17-year-old, well, it's the first time really that he has registered. Certainly his first final, and to be on the podium is not a bad thing at all. And Franquillo misses again. Two out of the last three. Garcia, the last two. But he comes good there. Bagroff to keep his advantage. High into the left. That was a tricky one for Franquillo. Did very well. So then, the last target from Garcia. Qualified top. He's not going to be top of the podium, though. And Quido would like this one just to stay in touch as they head to the last 10 targets. And that's a real trick one, wide and to the right and high. And he did really, really well to bag it. He stays in the competition. This is the man who's leaving. Spain getting the bronze. Well done to Andreas Garcia. Bagroff going into the lead after those two misses from Franquillo. But there is a long way to go. 10 more targets to be precise. Okay, Bagroff and Franquillo, the last two. The Russians and the Italians, always rivals when it comes to shotgun, cheering everything, and a miss from Franquillo. Oh dear. Two the difference then. Nine targets to go. Coaches watching on. Nothing they can do now, apart from take pride in how these two young men are doing. Bagroff, 17 years of age. Franquillo, 19 years of age. Bagroff, I think we'll see a lot more of him on the senior stage soon as well. straight down the middle, and that shouldn't be a problem, and wasn't for Bagroff. There's a comfortable cushion, but it could all change. Tranquillo just needs to concentrate on keeping hitting. Sun low in the sky from their left-hand side. Shouldn't be an issue. Ooh, and a miss from Bagroff. So then, might not be quite so comfortable. Certainly not for the coach. So, down to one the difference. And another miss from Bagroff. What is happening? Two in a row from the Russian. And that was nicely done. So we're level after 45 targets, five to go. Will we be going to a shoot-off? It's really tight, isn't it? Pat Live, one to the right for Bagroff, no problems at all. Now Tranquillo. No target. Little puff of dust breaks as it comes out. This is where the mental toughness is a very important part of the training. Better from Bagroff. Two out of the last two. Back on track. Running out of targets here. A miss would be really disastrous for either of these athletes. Three more each. Unless we go to a shoot-off. Climbing. But no problems for Bagroff, who will just wander across the next station and wait his go. Now Tranquillo, under pressure to keep up with Bagroff. And does as well. Big cheers from the Italians. Good atmosphere here, despite the fact we obviously can't have general public in here. Oh, just about got that one. $39 apiece. Bagroff on the far right-hand side of the five shooting positions. And got a nibble. Again, wasn't perhaps as fulsome as you'd have liked, but it doesn't matter. High to the left. Tranquillo doesn't miss. Last target then of the 50. Will we be going to a shoot-off? Well, it's all down to Lorenzo Tranquillo now. Oh, was that a miss? Was that a miss? There was no hand going up from the referee. Whew, that was close. He must have got something on that target. I think he thought he'd missed as well. Just having a word with the referee of smile. He's walking off to get some more ammunition. It is a shoot-off. There you go. Yeah, a little puff before we lost the target. Ooh, that was close for a moment. I thought that was a miss. the target. The signs flashed up red momentarily before they corrected. So Bagaroff against Franquillo. Immediate shoot-off, and it is a sudden death. And we go to the first station on the left-hand side. Bathed in sunshine at the moment. It will be the Russian Bagaroff. It will shoot first, higher bib number, of course. And this for the junior gold medal in the trap men competition. So pressure back on Franquillo. Bagaroff watching on. Round we go to station number two. Bagaroff again, with a chance to put pressure on Franquillo. 17-year-old against a 19-year-old. Both about to get their first junior medals, but what colour will they be? Best in trap for Franquillo, 45th in a junior World Cup competition a couple of years ago. This is a massive step up. Oh, and was that a miss? Yes, it was. So Russia take the gold medal. It had to go to a shoot-off, though. Well done to Lorenzo Franquillo, who pushed him all the way. Gold medal, though, going to Kirill Bagaroff of Russia. Both those athletes will be delighted with a medal and a place on the podium. As I said, Franquillo never really been in this position before. Bagaroff, a little bit more experienced perhaps, but again, had to keep his nerve in the shoot-off. He knew straight away it was a miss. And so did Bagaroff. And a chance now to celebrate. Those are our three medalists. Well done to them in an excellent competition. Andres Garcia of Spain with the bronze, Lorenzo Franquillo of Italy with the silver, and Kirill Bagaroff of Russia taking the gold.